I have no clue if this video is in shot or not, but we're gonna do it. I have started my timer, and today's video I'm going to be doing the strip down challenge that I've been seeing a lot of other YouTubers doing. It was created by Jonah Green in response to Asena O'Neill, I think her name was, about quitting social media, and I just kind of wanted to put in my take on this. I know I already have videos planned and set up and everything, and this is going to be like an extra video because I am putting it on my main channel because I have more subscribers there. I know that kind of like defeats the purpose of what Asena O'Neill was saying, but it's not to give it to the people, it's just so more people view it and more people can see it, I guess. So this video is going to be 10 minutes long, no cuts, no music, no editing whatsoever. Like, there won't be an outro at the end, my intro thing won't be in here, and it's just gonna be me talking to you. And I know some people have done it like different things, but I kind of wanted to keep on the topic of like social media and stuff. I am 17 years old and I have grown up around social media my entire life, and I was always told by my parents and by other people and by strangers that social media was bad, that it was like harming the generation, the millennials basically, and that it was putting ideas into our heads and that it was horrible and that everybody on the internet was horrible or a pedophile. And I am gonna be completely honest and say that is the furthest thing from the truth. I appreciate Asena O'Neill's video, and what she's doing is clearly the best option that she has for herself, but I did not appreciate how she was there generally saying that everybody on the internet, whether it's YouTube or Instagram or Twitter or anything, that it's fake. I don't appreciate that, because me, I consider myself a very, very small social media personality, I guess, because I mean, I'm a YouTuber, I have less than 200 subscribers, and she is sitting there talking about how numbers make you feel good, and how, like, you get addicted. And I can say that, yeah, numbers make me feel good. No, seeing my subscriber count go up is a great feeling, but it's not a great feeling because, oh my god, numbers, I have such a mass following. No, the reason I think it feels good to me is because, wow, I'm reaching out to all these people. I do a lot of videos that you guys might not know, you might know. I do trans education videos where I talk about LGBT issues. I have had other videos talking about mental illness, and I plan to do so much more of that in the future. So with the increased following, that's a chance for me that I'm reaching out to more people and that I could be helping more people. And I think that's one of the realest things on social media. Like, I don't think that I'm a fake person on the internet. My videos do contain editing, but frankly, a lot of like my trans education videos and stuff about mental illness, it's got very, very minimal editing to it. I mean, the only thing I cut out are like long silences. I don't cut out things that I say. I don't cut out any of that because I want everything that I say, no matter what it is, it could help somebody. And I take that to heart, and I want to be able to help as many people as I can through my videos with stuff like that. And I feel like that's such a real thing to do. And when she says that everybody is fake on the internet and they're all doing it for money, like, I don't believe that to be true at all. I have over 1k followers on Twitter and over 3k on Instagram, and those numbers are awesome. Getting likes and getting retweeted is, I mean, yeah, it feels good. I'm not gonna deny that it gives you a sense of, hey, wow, people like what I'm putting out there. But the thing is that she went through and changed like the captions to all of her Instagram photos, and she was like, this is fake, this wasn't candid, blah, 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 blah. And yeah, I can see how that was like a good thing for her. But for me, like, yeah, I'll be the first to admit, I go out and I'm like, hey, while we're here, I want to get a really, really good picture for my Instagram. And I want to showcase what I'm doing. I want it to be awesome. Whether it's the photo that I take or a photo somebody else takes with me in it, I really love being able to capture these moments because it's not just for Instagram and for likes. It's for me and for me to be able to look back and be like, hey, this was a really freaking cool day and I love this picture. I'm not sitting there trying to be a fake person on the internet, and I think that's usually how most people are. A lot of people who are older than us deem the internet as this horrible, god-awful hell of a place where kids are just, I guess, where kids are having their minds melted, and I don't understand why that is. I use social media a lot, and I'm not gonna deny that. And I'll say I'm addicted to social media, but I'm not gonna sit there and say social media is a horrible thing and that it's the worst thing in the world, because social media has given me pretty much every single friend that I have. Friends in real life I have made because they saw that I was starting YouTube and they were like, hey, that's cool, can I start that? They messaged me. That's because of social media. Friends that I have that I met through Tyler Oakley's meetup, I met them. We're all there because of social media, because of Tyler Oakley. And Tyler Oakley is a social media personality. Some people I met there, I talked to on Twitter the day before, and we're like, hey, let's meet up. I met them through social media. My best friends, the ones that are on the collab channel with me, Quite the Collab, the six of them are some of the best people I could have ever asked for in my life. And I would not know them if it was not for YouTube and social media. I do not agree with saying that social media is a bad place. I think you can say that social media is a bad place for you if you feel that way, but I do not respect people who go around saying social media is such a horrible place for everybody, because social media is such a good place for me. I have ways to talk to people with similar interests, to reach out to people who need help, and that's something that means so much to me. Majority of my friends, I've never even met in person, and a lot of people are like, oh, if you've never met them in person or like hugged them, like they're not a friend. And I think that's a load of bullshit, because I've met them online and they're some of the best people I know. I'm gonna be completely honest, and they are great, and I couldn't ask for better people in my life. And social media is just, in general, not a bad place. You can get into bad spaces on social media. When I was younger, I was probably 12, 13, 14, when I was dealing with my horrid, like, beginning stages of my crippling, of my depression, and, like, before I went inpatient and everything, I was on horrible sides of social media. I had secret accounts. I was seeing pictures of people self-harm, and it was just like re-triggering myself. And I'm not gonna say that that doesn't exist, because it does, and I was in there, and I was there. But you know what? After I started to feel a little bit better after my second time at the hospital, I said, screw this. I deleted all of those accounts. I unfollowed every single Tumblr blog that posted anything like that. And I restarted on social media, and let me tell you, it was such a good decision on my part, because now social media is such a positive and bright place, and I can share what I'm feeling. If it's sad, it's sad, because I know I'm really fucking sad right now, because I just found out yesterday that my dog, my Sadie, you guys probably know her, that you've seen in vlogs or you've seen pictures if you follow me on stuff, she has cancer. And this is probably gonna be her last Christmas if she makes it that long. And I didn't keep that a secret. Like, people like to make out and say that everybody only shares the positive aspects of their life on social media. And I don't think that's true. I put out there, hey, my dog is dying. My best friend that I have had since I was 2 years old is gonna die. And that's not a positive thing to think about. And I've been a disaster area for the last day, and the only reason I'm probably not sobbing is because my tear ducts are dry and my eyes are very itchy because of it. And I put out there, and I was just very honest, and I was like, look, she's my best friend. If I'm gonna take, I'm just gonna be sad for a bit. Like, I'm allowed to be sad. And I think the good thing about posting like being your genuine self on social media is that I put on there, I was like, hey, please keep me, my family, and above else, my dog Sadie, in your thoughts, in your prayers. And because for me, that's a big thing, is having people like think about, and like spiritually, I guess, I don't know, I'm getting off track, but social media is not an evil place. If you make it an evil place, it can be an evil place. But if you don't, it'll be great. And that is the timer. It's been 10 minutes already. That's went by really quickly. I might do other videos like this, I'm thinking. I feel like I will continue stripped down videos where I just sit here and talk without edits. If you guys like about other issues like social media or like, I don't know. You guys let me know if I could do it like in trans education videos or anything like that. If you're watching, I think that'd be really cool if you could let me know if you want to do that more. So yeah, I hope you enjoyed this video, and I'm not going to say like it or comment or whatever. I mean, you can do that if you want, you can subscribe if you want, but this is not a video to promote myself. And I think I'm going to tag everybody in my collab channel to do this video and to do a strip down challenge. So that's all I have right now. I hope you enjoyed unedited, filtered me, I guess. And see you tomorrow with the trans education video. Love you guys. Bye. See, this is what happens when that's not the button and it's an unedited video.